Hello, I'm Jason Radebaugh, a TME at InfoBlox. Today, I'll show you how to deploy a BloxOne on-prem host, or OPH, in Microsoft Azure, using our purpose-built Azure image. Deploying BloxOne on-prem hosts in Azure allows you to provide BloxOne services such as BloxOne DDI and BloxOne Threat Defense to workloads running in your Azure virtual networks. This is an overview of the steps used to deploy a BloxOne OPH in Azure. First, you'll need to download the virtual hard disk, or VHD, from the InfoBlox Cloud Services portal and create a join token. Next, you'll upload the VHD to a storage account in Azure. From the Azure portal, you'll create a custom image using the VHD and then deploy a virtual machine from this image. Finally, you can complete setup of the OPH in the InfoBlox CSP. Now let's take a look at a live demo of deploying a BloxOne on-prem host in Azure. First, I'll use the InfoBlox Cloud Services portal to download a VHD and create a join token. Navigate to Administration, Downloads, select the Download Package for Azure, and click on Download Package. While this is downloading, I'll create a join token. Navigate to Manage On-Prem Hosts, select Join Tokens, and click on Create. I'll enter a name for my token, and click Save and Close. In the Copy Token window, I'll click Copy and store this token securely to use in deployment. Next, I'll upload the VHD to an Azure storage account using the Azure VHD Utils command line tool. This upload can take a while, and I'll need to wait for it to complete before continuing my deployment. Now that my upload is complete, I'll go to the Azure portal to create an image and deploy my OPH VM. In the search bar, I'll search for Image and select Images. Click on Create to add a new image. Select my resource group. Enter a name for my image. Select Linux for OS type. Enter the URL for the VHD I uploaded. Select the storage type to use, and then click Review and Create. On the Review page, I'll review details and ensure validation is passed. And then I'll click on Create. Once the image is created, I'll click on Go to Resource, then click on Create VM. On the Basics tab, I'll ensure the correct subscription and resource group are selected. I'll enter a name for the virtual machine. I can select an availability option, such as availability zones. Select a size for the virtual machine. I'll select password for authentication type. Enter a username. Enter and confirm a password. I don't want to allow any public access. For licensing type, I'll select Other, and then click on Next Disks. Here I can select a disk type for this VM and click on Next Networking. On the Networking tab, I'll select my virtual network and subnet. I don't need a public IP for this VM. Next, I'll go to the Advanced tab. Here, I'll add my join token to the custom data field in a YAML format so that this OPH can connect to the InfoBlox CSP. I'll click on Review and Create. On the Review page, I'll review details of my virtual machine and ensure validation is passed, then click Create. Once the VM creation is complete, I can view my new resources in the resource group. To finish setting up my new on-prem host, I'll return to the InfoBlox CSP, navigate to Manage, On-Prem Hosts. I can identify my new Azure host by the name which includes the name of the join token I used, or by the host type, BloxOne VM Azure. To complete configuration, I'll click on Edit. Here I can rename the host and enable applications and services that I need, such as DNS. Thanks for watching. For additional videos and other resources on Infoblox BloxOne, visit infoblox.com or our community site at community.infoblox.com.